Hey everyone, it is Friday. I hope your day is going well. We've been looking at passages from 1 Thessalonians. This is Paul's letter to the church that he planted in the city of Thessalonica. It's one of Paul's earliest letters. It was written shortly after his time there in Thessalonica. That's recorded in the 17th chapter of the book of Acts. Now, in the third chapter of 1 Thessalonians, Paul tells the people there that he had been worried greatly that they might crumble under persecution, or that they might be discouraged when they heard about all of his problems and troubles. He says that he longed to come back to Thessalonica for another visit, but he was prevented from doing so. And so he sent Timothy to check in on them. And here's what Paul says about Timothy's report. It's found in 1 Thessalonians 3, 6 through 10. Paul writes, "But Timothy has just now come to us from you and has brought good news about your faith and love. He's told us that you always have pleasant memories of us and that you long to see us just as we also long to see you. Therefore, brothers and sisters, in all our distress and persecution, we were encouraged about you because of your faith. For now we really live since you are standing firm in the Lord. How can we thank God enough for you in return for all the joy we have in the presence of our God because of you? Night and day we pray most earnestly that we may see you again and supply what is lacking in your faith." Now, did you hear that? What brought Paul joy? What brought him joy was seeing his new friends grow in their faith and hold steady. Paul is overjoyed to hear that the church that he planted there in Thessalonica is holding fast to their new faith in Jesus Christ. I'd like you to think about a friend or a family member or a classmate that you know needs to walk with Christ, needs to know Jesus. Think of the joy it would bring you to see them embrace a walk with Christ. Well, what are we going to do about it? What are you going to do about it? Why not pray for the right opportunity to share a word, a prayer, an invitation with that person, to share a word about Christ with them? Now, you don't have to force it. You'll know when the time is right. Actually, God promises to give us the words. And we know that God is good all the time.